What is going on, guys? Don checking in. Welcome to Mint, where we bring nursing to you. So today, we are going to talk about blood types. We are going to talk about antigens, antibodies, and Rh factor. You got your notes ready? Because I'm ready. Let's get going.
Today, we're going to talk about blood types. These blood types are type A, type B, type AB, and type O. For us to understand these blood types, we first need to understand the concepts of antigens and antibodies. Let's start with antigens. Antigens are what we call surface markers. They are called surface markers because they can be found within the surface of the red blood cell. So if this is your red blood cell, these are your antigens. They're on the surface of the red blood cells. They're called markers because the blood type that you have depends on what kind of antigen you have on your red blood cell. So if you have an A antigen within your red blood cell, your blood type is a type A blood. So if you have a B antigen on the surface of your red blood cell, your blood type is the type B blood. Now, if your red blood cell contains both antigen A and antigen B, your blood type is type AB. Now, if you do not have any antigens on your red blood cell, then you are a type O. Now, we can remember this as zero, meaning you have zero antigens on your red blood cell. That is a type O blood type. So aside from surface markers, these antigens have another important function, and that is these antigens can trigger an immune response. And for them to do this, they have to interact with antibodies. In contrast with these antibodies are found outside the red blood cell. They are found within the plasma. And the primary action of these antibodies are to interact with an opposite antigen to trigger an immune response. So let us discuss antibodies of each blood types that we have, starting off with type A blood. The way our blood works is that usually we have an opposite antibodies in relation to our antigens. So if we have an A antigen on a red blood cell, our antibodies are anti-B antibodies. So by its name, anti-B, it will only attack B antigens. What do I mean by that? So if a type A person gets a type A blood, there will be no reaction or immune response. Why? Because these antibodies will only react to B antigens. But if this person gets a blood type B, these antibodies will interact with the B antigens because they are anti-B, meaning they will go to these antigens and destroy them. This is usually the transfusion reaction that people experience when they receive an incompatible blood type. Now let's talk about type B blood. Again, antibodies are usually opposite of the antigens. Now for this blood type who has a B antigen, you will have anti-A antibodies. You get a type B blood, there will be no reaction. Why? Because these will only react to antigen A. B antigens, no reaction. However, if you get a type AB blood, wherein you have both type A and type B antigens, these are anti-A antibodies. They will still interact with the A antigens of this red blood cell, causing a transfusion reaction. Next blood type is for type AB blood. Remember, always the opposite, right? So if both antigens are present on the surface of this red blood cell, the opposite of both, there will be no antibodies floating around the plasma. So if you get a type A blood, no reaction will take place. Why? Because there's no antibodies, right? Same goes if you put a type AB blood or a type B blood or a type O blood. No reaction will take place for this patient who have AB blood type because there are no antibodies in this person's blood. This is why a person with a type AB blood, they are considered to be the universal recipient, meaning they can have any types of blood, type A, type AB, type B, type O. There will be no reaction. Now let's move forward to type O blood. O meaning zero antigens, right? So again, the opposite concept of antibodies and antigens. If you do not have any antigens on the surface of a type O blood, what do you think you have on the plasma? We have anti-A and anti-B antibodies. Always the opposite. Zero antigens, anti-A and anti-B antibodies in the plasma. having anti-A and anti-B antibodies on the plasma, this can only mean one thing, and that is it can only get a type O blood type, because type O blood type does not have any antigens on the surface, meaning these anti-A and anti-B will have no antigens to attack. Only type O blood types can be given to a type O patient, meaning if you give a patient a type A blood, anti-A antibodies will attack this blood type because you have A antigens. The same goes with type B blood because we have anti-B antibodies. Since type O blood does not contain any antigens on the surface, this blood type can be considered to be a universal donor. Check this out. If you give this type O blood on a person with type A blood, meaning they have A antigens here and they will have anti-B antibodies, these antibodies will not react because they don't have any antigens to react to, right? The same goes with blood type B, where they have B antigens on the surface and they have anti-A antibody. These antibodies cannot destroy this. No antigens present. And of course, type AB person who does not have any antibodies will have no reaction at all, thus making type O blood to be a universal donor. And the way you're going to remember this is that type O for donor, so O, they're both O's. Zero antigens are universal donor. So let us review. Type A blood will have A antigens on the surface of the red blood cell, and for the antibodies, they will have anti-B. Type B blood type will have B antigens on the surface of the red blood cell, and they will have an anti-A antibodies. Type AB blood type will have both A and B antigens. They will not have any antibodies on their plasma. And lastly, type O blood type, they will not have any antigens on the surface of the red blood cell, but they will have anti-A and anti-B antibodies. So again, it's always the opposite. A antigen, anti-B. B antigen, anti-A. A and B antigens, no antibodies. Zero antigens, you will have anti-A and anti-B antibodies. So with these blood types, let's see what kind of blood types they will be compatible with. So for type A blood type, you can have type A blood and a type O blood. Anti-B won't have any reactions to this because it has only A antigens, and anti-B won't have any reaction to this because it does not have any antigens on the surface. For type B blood, we can have type B blood and type O. Again, no reactions for anti-A because this have B antigens and this does not have any antigens on the surface. For type AB blood, you can have type A, type B, type AB, and type O. So because there are no antibodies on this blood type, AB blood types can receive AB, AB, and O, making AB the universal recipient. And lastly, for type O blood, you can only have type O, just because anti-A, anti-B can potentially destroy A, B, and AB, you can only have type O blood for a type O blood type. As you can see, for every category, A, B, AB, and O, type O blood types can be given to these blood types, making type O blood types to be the universal donor. O for zero antigen and O for universal donor. Now that we are familiar with what is compatible for each blood type, let us briefly talk about the Rh factor. The Rh factor usually tells us whether you are a positive blood type or a negative blood type. So if you have an Rh factor on the surface of your red blood cells, such as these, your blood type will be a positive blood type. If you have A antigens on your red blood cells plus the Rh factor, that makes you an A positive blood type. For B antigens with the Rh factor, that makes you a B positive blood type. For A and B antibodies on the surface plus the Rh factor, you're going to have an AB positive blood type. And lastly, zero antigens, but with an Rh factor, you are going to have an O positive blood type. So think about this way. The positive simply indicates the presence of these Rh factor on the surface of your red blood cell. However, the absence of the Rh factor on the surface of your red blood cells make you a negative blood type. So for A antigens without the Rh factor, that makes you an A negative blood type. Same goes with the B antigens. No Rh factor, that makes you a B negative blood type. A and B antigens, no Rh factors, AB negative blood type. And lastly, no antigens, no Rh factor, that makes you an O negative blood type. Now, looking at this chart, we have already established what blood types are compatible with each blood type. When we add Rh factor in the equation, it gets more specific. Let's talk about it. So for positive blood types, they can have a positive and negative blood types. So for patients with A positive blood types, they can have blood that are A positive, O positive, A negative, and O negative. The same goes with B positive blood types. So if you have a patient with a B positive blood type, they can have a B positive blood type, O positive, B negative, and O negative. A B positive, they can have A positive, B positive, AB positive, O positive. They can also have A negative, B negative, AB negative, and O negative blood types. And finally, for patients with O positive blood types, they can have an O positive or an O negative blood types. However, it gets different when you have a negative blood type, meaning you do not have any Rh factor on the surface of your red blood cell. So if you have a negative blood type, you can only have a negative blood type as a donor, meaning for A negative patients, you can only have A negative and O negative blood types. For B negative blood types, you can only have B negative and O negative blood types. For AB negative, you can only have A negative, B negative, AB negative, and O negative. And finally, for O negative blood types, you can only have a negative blood type. Again, for positive blood types, meaning positive Rh factors on the surface of their red blood cell, they can have a positive and negative blood type. For negative blood types, they can only have negative blood types. That's it.
So that is it for today, guys. I hope you guys found that video helpful. If you haven't already, please hit the like and subscribe button. By doing this, our videos will go straight to you. But don't forget to hit the notification bell button so you guys get notified when we upload new videos. Once again, my name is Don, Mint, signing out.